Hello from the Mars Society. We hope you're enjoying this holiday season and spending time with your family and friends. As we begin our 25th year as an organization, we'd like to take a moment to review our current programs and initiatives and tell you a little bit about what we plan to do in the coming year. The 22nd field season is underway at the Mars Desert Research Station. There have been over a dozen crews scheduled for this field season that runs until next May. Two missions have already been completed. Crews 267 and 268 were both comprised of all female crew members. They recently completed their missions and have brought important field experience to their organizations, advancing their own research as well as our overall theme, the human factors challenges of operating on Mars. There are crew slots available now in the next 2 to 3 years, and so we encourage everyone to apply. Applications are open now, and you can find out more on our program's website. We're now planning our first mission in 5 years to our Arctic base. In 2023, the Mars Society will send a crew to the Flashline Mars Arctic Research Station, located on Devon Island in the extreme north of Canada. We built the facility in the year 2000 and have operated it on a periodic basis for the last 22 years. This will be the first mission to the station since 2017. We anticipate sending a crew that's not only made up of people that can get the facility up and running again, but also those that can participate in a science-based field simulation. The cost of this mission is over $100,000, which includes traveling up to that area of the Arctic, as well as the retrofit and operational costs of the mission. We are planning to organize a crew of 6 to 8 people, and those crew members should be able to raise at least $20,000 individually for the mission. If you're interested, please contact us at this email address. Next are our educational programs, which we're planning to expand next year. This past summer, we organized our first International Mission to Mars engineering design course and competition, and we're planning to do that again next summer. We're currently seeking funding to expand the program, which has proven to be very successful. Last summer, we had over 40 students comprised of 5 teams that competed. Each team turned in amazing work, and all were able to participate in the presentations and debates. At our recent conference at Arizona State University, we featured this competition on a panel, and many of the teams also attended and presented. We anticipate other educational program announcements next year because we have a lot of ideas, and we're looking for more funding to make sure those ideas can be fully developed. Watch our website for updates on program registrations, and please share information on our educational programs with all the young people in your life. Next, in the area of outreach, is our Mars Society Ambassador Program. We're in the process of certifying our first 50 ambassadors. This will be a cadre of people from all around the world with their diverse backgrounds and cultures, able to speak intelligently about humans to Mars to their local communities. We see the Mars Society Ambassador Program as a key initiative in the future as we work to inspire the generation that will settle Mars. You can help the Mars Society in many ways. Join us by becoming an annual member. You can also volunteer for one of the programs I've mentioned or many of the other volunteer opportunities that we'll have throughout the year. Finally, you can donate to the Mars Society. Most of our organization is run by our annual donations, and so we very much appreciate whatever people are able to give. Using our donation form, it's easy to make a one-time donation or a recurring gift. So please give generously. Thank you for your support of the Mars Society. We look forward to a productive 2023 and continuing the momentum that will bring humans to Mars.